I just fixed two major bugs with the CalVPN beta. Some people couldn't subscribe properly. It was getting stuck in this loop. And some people couldn't use their credentials to sign in. They're both fixed. Silly little bugs. Has nothing to do with the app itself. So everything works very smoothly. If you guys could come try again and let me know down under if it works for you, that would help me out so much. I'll see you guys in the stream in a few hours. I need some sleep. Those damn bugs are worse than bed bugs for your sleep.
Fuck.
Why do you keep doing this to us?
I don't know, Morty. Maybe I hate myself. We need a vacation.
All right. The crazy future if protons don't decay.
Beginning has an end. Atoms, humans, black holes, and even the universe itself travel 20 times more into the future to 1 trillion years. Stars will start decaying into white dwarfs, neutron stars, and black holes, giving the start of the degenerate era. No laugh.
Okay, this is great. Thank you, whoever recommended this.
That's why he's the MVP! That's why he's the GOAT! The GOAT!
I've created the world's first post-quantum VPN. It has post-quantum cryptographic algorithms that can literally protect you from quantum computers. That's going to be trouble in the next few years. So if you want to come use it, come download it. It's in the description, calvpn.com. The beta is out. If you're new in my stream today and you didn't hear, the beta is out and you can go use it. This has post-quantum cryptography, which is basically just hard math problems, and you can use it. And this will save you from getting retroactively hacked, because hackers can actually steal VPN encrypted data right now. And then in the future, if they have one of these devices, they can decrypt your data that they stole. But anyway, let's get back to the video.
What happens next depends on whether protons decay or not, which we don't know for sure. But for the sake of simplicity, we'll assume they do, and leave the other possibility for another video.
If you didn't get the degenerate error thing, there's a thing called degeneracy pressure for things. So
the prophecy is true.
Hello, mortals. What do you imagine when hearing about iron? A relatively common ore found in most Minecraft caves, that mysterious thing that no college student is aware of, or the thing that could make up the last stars in the universe. If it wouldn't already take a painstakingly long amount of time for the universe to cool down and die through the heat death, let's add the possible factor of matter not decaying at all into the equation. In a previous video, I talked about whether or not protons decay after 10 deuterocillion years, thus leaving nothing but photons and leptons behind. The thing is, scientists don't yet know if protons decay or not, and the standard model doesn't suggest that they should ever become unstable and decay. So let's look at this possibility. What if protons do never decay? Thanks to Blinkist for sponsoring this video. First of all, why do particles even decay? The short answer is that they are lazy. Relatable, isn't it?
Nice.
Everything in the universe tends to a more stable state, and you are more stable when you have less potential energy to spend. For example, if you were to stand on your feet and suddenly lose consciousness, you will begin to fall, as your body seeks to spend all of its potential energy and lower its energy level. For the same reason you sleep lying in bed and not like a flamingo. In the case of particles, they too want to lower their energy level by simply decaying into other smaller particles. If you somehow rip a neutron out of a nucleus and leave it by itself, after roughly 15 minutes, it will decay into a proton and emit an electron. Protons are lighter than the neutrons, so they have less energy.
Is this meant to be like a sciencey actual video or a comedy plus science? Like, am I meant to just laugh, or do we want to talk about things?
And thus, are more stable. Also, both the neutron and the proton are baryons, so after the decay, the type of the particle remains unchanged. It's only the energy that decreases. In the case of protons, however, there are just no other baryons in which they could decay, as the proton is the lightest of them. This should mean that the proton is in its most stable form, and there is nothing lower they could decay into. So, how will this fact change the future of our universe?
You might be thinking quarks. What about quarks, which make up protons? We don't think you can really have quarks by themselves.
Let's fast travel to the degenerate era, when there is nothing but black holes, fading stars, and rogue planets. After some long time, and I really mean a long, long time, all matter as we know it
there will be some other things, by the way.
will slowly decay into iron. As I said, the universe is very lazy, and iron has the lowest energy level out of all elements because it has the most tightly bound nuclei. Any element that is heavier than iron, like copper, gold, or plutonium, will decay over time by nuclear fission into iron. The element with the longest half-life is tellurium, which will decay in 10 to the power of 24 years, which is 160 trillion times greater than the age of the universe. And yet, this rather extensive period of time can be thought of as a blink compared to the time that lighter elements need to transform into iron. The only way this can happen is through cold fusion. Unlike thermonuclear fusion, that happens inside the core of stars, cold fusion occurs under any temperature and pressure. During nuclear fusion inside the stars, nuclei are so close together that the nuclear force surpasses the repulsive electromagnetic force and eventually sticks them together, releasing a lot of energy and creating heavier elements in the process. But at low temperatures, nuclei are so far apart from each other that only magic would make them pass through the electromagnetic force barrier. And that magic is called quantum tunneling, the process of a particle.
It's not magic. It's not magic.
Getting through a barrier simply by teleportation and some shady quantum stuff. The denser that force barrier is, the less likely the particle is to tunnel through it. In the case of matter in the cold and far future of the universe, the chance of this happening is incredibly small, but not equal to zero. It is estimated that all matter will fuse into iron through cold fusion and quantum tunneling after 10 to the power of 3,200 years. All these iron atoms would come together in clumps to make iron.
So it should probably be pointed out that, you know, as funny as this video is, there's a lot of this stuff is not exactly, there's no reason to sort of trust a lot of it or believe it. It's just some random theoretical papers which probably have, you know, no citations and things like that.
Stars, the last objects to exist inside the universe.
If that, you know, so I'm not looking into some of these things, so some of you might know.
To put this giant amount of time in perspective, if you replace every atom in the observable universe with another observable universe full of atoms, and then you replace these atoms with another observable universes, and repeat this cycle 40 times, you'll have in total this many atoms. If you counted one atom per year in this super universe, it would still not be enough for all the elements to turn into iron. During this process, it is thought that some black dwarfs will explode into supernovas after 10 to the power of 1,100 years because of the accumulating iron. Even though new elements will arise from nuclear fusion during the explosions, they will transform into iron relatively fast. These supernovas will-
This was also very dependent on, like, you know, the way the universe dies, whatever happens in the far distant future, we actually don't know. So, you know, he's saying if, and not if, like, they decay, but it's also dependent on, like, what happens as well. So there's multiple things, and we made a couple videos if you want to go hear some of the ways things might end up. So there's a whole bunch, right?
Will be the last fireworks our universe will ever see. But as we already know, this will not happen soon at all. But if you are as impatient as I am, I have the perfect solution while we're waiting for the ionization of the universe. Blinkist, our longtime sponsor, the video. Everything until now was just a minuscule fraction on the timescale of the universe. For all it remains, iron stars will very slowly collapse into black holes.
That's not true. Do you mean fall into them? Because they'll be, but even then, like, if things keep expanding, you know, so that doesn't make a whole lot of sense. There's a lot of things you could say there, which result in that not making any sense. They're not, if you just leave them alone, going to collapse into black holes.
Whether through gravity or the aforementioned quantum tunneling. And this process will take an inconceivable amount of time, 10 to the power of 10 to the power of 76 years.
That's a big number. These are the sorts of numbers you can come across in thermodynamics, called very big numbers, very, very, very big numbers.
76 years. That's like writing a zero for each atom in the universe in order to make up the time frame. Eventually, the newly formed black holes will evaporate through Hawking radiation. But this process only takes 10 to the power of 108 years at most for the most supermassive black holes, which, at this time period, is nothing but an instance compared to the lifetime of the iron stars. So you could say that
it's literally nothing but an instant for the photons around, because they don't experience time. Yeah, 10 to the 108, that's a larger than a Google.
Role of dark energy in all of making them the actual winners of Universe Battle Royale. Transform into black holes.
Wait, what is he
saying?
Compared
to the lifetime of the Iron Stars. So you could say that, at this time scale, the Iron Stars will just disappear the moment they transform into black holes, making them the actual winners of Universe Battle Royale.
I don't know why he thinks they'll turn into black holes, but also, again, this is dependent on what happens. You know what I mean? There's so many things that could happen.
What happens next is very speculative.
For something to collapse to form a black hole, you need to have a lot of mass in one place. And to get a lot of mass in one place, you need, you know, forces. And you need to squash something below its Schwarzschild radius, and then it collapses into a black hole. But to do that is not exactly easy. You need, like, to squash Earth to the size of a peanut. If you can do that, you'll form a black hole. But imagine how much force it takes to do that, right? So I don't know what he's suggesting is happening here. Maybe in this future that he's talking about, you know, the universe is, and you know what I mean? Like, just having it sit there and then just collapse into a black hole doesn't make a lot of sense. But there's also something to worry about called entropy. Everything does degenerate eventually, we think. Even diamonds.
Iron stars will just disappear the moment they transform into black holes, making them the actual winners of Universe Battle Royale.
Battle Royale. It is like a big battle royale when you look at it like this.
What happens next is very speculative, as we don't know what the role of dark energy in all of this is. But everything left after the death of the Iron Stars are just photons and leptons, like electrons and positrons, flying around for almost eternity. The next checkpoint being the birth of a new Big Bang in about 10 to the power of 10 to the power.
So yeah, like talking about this part is all of this is quite, you know, speculatory, but these bits are extremely speculatory. And so I guess he likes the idea of cyclic cosmology, you know, talking about a Big Bang being born again. And you know, you might have heard Roger Penrose talking about it. Don't take all of this too seriously. I think it's meant to be an entertaining video, but it can be dangerous because, like, people think, I don't know, it's not dangerous at all, but just people get the wrong idea, misinformed.
Power of 10 to the power of 10 to the power of 76 years, if we're looking at...
That's a stupidly big number.
...at the probability of quantum fluctuations, which makes the lifespan of iron stars a mere joke.
Like, you can't just say that.
And I'm not even comparing it to the current age of the universe. So yeah, do what you feel like doing. We're insignificant.
Are we though? Are we though? How do we know that? Couldn't possibly know if we're significant, you know? We actually might be the whole reason things are happening. Who knows, man? That's philosophy, right? So there's another video. I enjoyed that one. That was actually amazing. So let's subscribe to them. 700K. Very nice. What's next?